Ah, snap, it's Pokemon. Actually, that was a little premature because technically Pokemon didn't actually show up yet. Shit. Anyway, I'm sorry about the chair creaks if that came through. If it didn't, well, fuck. Anyway, this is going to be a Nuzlocke run of Pokemon Soul Silver. Gen 2 has always been a personal favorite of mine, and it is, you know, widely regarded that, you know, the Gen 4 remake of Gen 2 is probably one of the best Pokemon games there is. And, you know, I've been following the BrainScratch commentaries, Nuzlocke. At this point, they're about to do a second attempt at it, because, Ted died. He lost all of his Pokemon. Sad thing, really. Sad. If you see here, I did also, start a Nuzlocke run already. Wasn't intentionally initially going to record this, but I didn't have like a Capture 3DS, so I have to use an emulator, and then there was a whole bunch of issues with how slow the actual emulator itself was running, and I was having a bunch of issues and whatnot. Oh, hold on a sec. Anyway, I was having a whole bunch of issues with the way that the emulator itself was running. It just was running really slow, and I just didn't want to tax that, Sorry, I just kind of got lost in thought for a second. Anyway, I found the different methods on how to speed up the emulator so that it could actually run like it's, you know, not a piece of shit. And I guess if you're just looking at this now, you can pretty much notice that there's a little bit missing from the bottom of the screens. Well, you can notice that there's a little bit missing from the touch screen. Not so much the top screen now, because it's just black. Yeah, it's very interesting. Great place for me to stop. I'm just going to actually go... Hold on. I'm just going to go to new game here. Begin adventure. So if you'll notice, there's, once again, you really can't notice again because it's all solid. No info needed. Now if you notice, there's a little bit missing from the bottoms of both screens, and that is something that has to do with the way that, because I'm using the Windows 10 built-in DVR to record this. I'm not entirely sure if that's a good idea or a bad idea, but using the emulator's internal recording stuff really bogs down the actual emulator itself, and this seems to run really damn stable. So just deal with the missing little bits of screen. And if you're wondering why it's missing from both screens and not just the touchscreen, it's because I've actually have the screens horizontally right now, because if I don't do that, then a bigger chunk of the bottom screen will be missing, and I'd rather just have both be slightly taxed as opposed to just complete chaos. It just did not look good. Anyway, on to this. Yawn. Oh, guess. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, hi! It's Professor Oak. Professor Oak. But everybody calls me the Pokemon Professor. Literally nobody has called you that ever, other than yourself. General, just the totally overused opening. It's literally every game. Every damn game uses Professor Oak opening like this. And honestly, it's getting to the point that I'm a little annoyed by it. Oh, am I a boy or am I a girl? Now, if you notice, I won't be using the touchscreen at all because the Windows game DVR recorder leaves the mouse on screen, and I don't want to do that. So I'm doing everything. I'm actually using the Xbox One controller, believe it or not, to play this. Because it is much better to play this with a controller than it is with a keyboard and mouse. Well, I guess you wouldn't be using a mouse at all, you'd just be using a keyboard. And I'd much rather use a controller to control this. So, I am a boy. Yes, I am a boy. You could hear my manly voice. I've gone through puberty. Oh, I guess I had to press A twice. Please tell me your name. Alright. I am... I don't know why I didn't press select there, but, B-U-N-K. I am Bunk. Alright, my name is Bunk. No, it's not Bunk. I told you it's Bunk. But it's actually not Bunk. But I'm just gonna say yes anyway. Actually, you know what? I don't think I am ready for this, Professor Oak. Because I am in for some hard times, because this is a Nuzlocke run. Now I'm going by the exact way that Ted is playing the game. Mostly because this is sort of a fan run-ish, sort of, but not really. I'm literally only Nuzlocking this game because Ted is Nuzlocking this game. Well, he's Nuzlocking Heart Gold. Soul Silver is the better game. I'm saying it right now. I prefer Silver version, and I preferred Soul Silver over Heart Gold. And if you have a problem with that, well, I'm not saying you're wrong, because, you know, that's just mean, and I won't ever say that. Anyway, just let me get on to this actual Nuzlocke run here. Dreams, adventure, let the world of Pokemon, blah, 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 blah. Oh, it's that shot that was in the first Pokemon game, isn't it? Nostalgic. Yeah. It's a Wii! Wii is huge in Johto, too! Like, two as in also, but... I'm pretty sure I had to explain that I'm using a controller, just in case my mic actually winds up picking up the controller sounds, because I'm an idiot. And... also, I'm recording this all in one batch because, I think when I was trying to record, with the game DVR and Audacity separately, it was having issues, like audio desyncing issues. But I'm going to try recording all of this at once with the microphone, in the game DVR app. Well, not an app, but functionality. And I hope this comes out well. I think I'm gonna stop the recording every maybe, you know, it's got that nice timer in the corner there for me, which you can't see, but it's a nice corner that helps me a lot. And I'm probably gonna stop the recording about every 45 minutes or so, and like make sure that the audio is synced on at the end. And if it's synced at the end, then I know it's synced throughout. So that's pretty damn nice. And if it's not, I'm probably going to just scrub this and do it again. And nobody will ever know that I've ever done this. So there's really no point in... well, actually, yes, there is a point in saying this. Because if you're all hearing this, that means that I actually did not scrub it. And I actually uploaded it. Anyway. Anyway. You're not going to be able to see this because I'm going to... I probably shouldn't scratch my stubble into the mic, but you know what? My stubble was itchy. Anyway, I probably it's not interesting at all. But I'm playing this horizontally, as I said. I'm actually playing with the touchscreen first. For whatever reason, I decided to do it that way, and I kind of like it. So I'm just going to keep it like that. Other than that, let's get this ball rolling. Hey. Elm's Pokemon Lab. So this is the famous Elm Pokemon Lab. What are you staring at? No, that was actually probably my favorite part of Gen 2. He literally just fucking kicks you. and you get knocked back, but it loses a bit of its luster when it in that scene. It's not as good as the original. Pokeball, blah blah blah. Professor Elm, you'll never be as well known as Professor Oak. I really feel bad about you because I feel you're overlooked a whole bunch because you weren't really in the anime at all, and like the other professors were. And that kind of sucks because you're actually probably my favorite Pokemon professor. Which is probably a odd thing to say because, I don't know, because, you know, there's Professor Oak. And why would you ever say Professor Oak isn't the best? But, honestly, I like Professor Elm's personality more than I like Professor Oak's personality, to be perfectly honest. But yeah. I think that Professor Elm is probably one of, if not the best Pokemon professors. Alright, so I've got three choices of Pokemon here. Now, I could just easily mimic Ted and choose Cyndaquil. But, fun fact, I have never played Gen 2 choosing anything other than Totodile. So I'm going to choose Totodile. Actually, Totodile is probably one of my all-time favorite Pokemon. Actually, a lot of my favorite Pokemon are from Gen 2. Actually, I would say half of my favorite Pokemon are from Gen 2, and the other half are actually from Gen 5, which are probably two completely different, like, odd subsets to choose. But if I were to choose about, you know, my top 5 or 6 favorite Pokemon, the 3 from Gen 2 are... Ooh, actually, there's 4. There's 4 from Gen 2. There's Totodile, obviously. Then there's Heracross, Scizor, and Ampharos. Ampharos actually did not used to be up high until Mega Ampharos came out. And Mega Ampharos is probably my favorite Mega Pokemon. Anyway, I should probably give this little Totodile a name. Now, I've typically been giving Totodiles the name Hintos, because that's the name of a crocodile character I came up with when I was a kid. But I'm actually going to go with the original name that I gave my very first Totodile. It's Snappy. All right. Is Snappy the nickname you want to give? Yes, it is the nickname I want to give. Anyway, I guess I'll take this time to go a bit deeper into the specs of the what I'm using. I've already gone over the fact that I'm using the Xbox One controller. I'm using the Disumi. I don't think that's actually how it's pronounced, and I don't actually care to look up how it's pronounced. But the Disumi, I'm once again probably saying that wrong. Don't care. That emulator with the two screens side by side at 2.5 window size to minimize on the, because I'm guessing is that for whatever reason the Windows 10 game DVR is taking the size of the actual screens but shifting it up a bit for the toolbar up top, and I can't get rid of that toolbar up top to my knowledge. And I'm talking about where it says file view config and all that stuff. I got rid of the other toolbar that had like the pause button on it because I don't need it. I don't need the pause button. Pause button's stupid. I'm not gonna use it. Don't need a pause. Not gonna use save states. This is a safe, stateless run. Because it's a Nuzlocke run. Why would I ever use save states in a Nuzlocke run? I mean, fucking game saves fine on its own. I'm not gonna mess with that. Anyway. Let's see here. Mr. Pokemon goes everywhere and finds rarities in his own. And his aspect share grows. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, so the reason I went with 2.5 is because the window size changes sizes, but then that toolbar stays at the same size. And you know what? The bigger the screen is, the less screen is missing. So I can't really argue with that. I got potions. Those are going to be super helpful later on. Medicine pocket. Oh, by the way, I probably should do this real quick. Options, go fast, and change the window type as well. Which one do I want? The window type I typically use is actually not in this game. I remember. I'll use this one. I think this is the one I used when I played through. Play through the game. Alright. I'm also gonna save real quick. Press up select and B on the title screen if you want to erase the current save file. Oh. 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 Oh, hold on. I'm gonna get back to this exact moment really soon. I just need to press up, select, and B on the title screen. I'm gonna fast forward to this point. All right, and we're back. Oh, god damn. Oh my god. I don't know if I'm actually going to show any of that the whole process, but that took up 10 fucking minutes to do that and get back to this point. This is the beginning of the goddamn game! Anyway, I already did the saving a lot of data, fuck. I thought I already did the saving a lot of data, but I guess it adds more after you get Totodile or your starter, but fuck it. Anyway, you'll probably notice that the game is going to chug a bit. There's nothing I can do about that. I'm sorry. But as you can see, all that dilly-dallying that I did, just explaining everything, ate up 6 minutes to get there. Show it to my mom. I'm going to get the Poke Gear. Alright. Oh, before I do anything else, I'm going to actually check what nature Snappy is. Jolly nature. I don't remember what that means. Wait. Hold on. Oh, summary. There we go. That's right. I was looking at the wrong screen because it swapped, like I said. Alright, so that's speed up, special attack down. Oh. I mean, Feraligatr is a more physical water type, I believe. So, I guess that's not too bad. But I'd much rather prefer, like, something like special attack down, attack up. Or like, you know, there are 6 stats. Why is there no HP down? I mean, that'd be dumb. But, yes, I remember how to use a phone, Mom. A side note, I like the fact that they actually gave the mom something to do in Gen 2. Because the mom being, like, a starting game Pokemon Center was a little dumb. And actually having her, you know, be a bank and get buy you items was pretty cool. Though it was arguably more of a novelty in the original Gen 2, but you know what? It's still cool. It's still a cool feature. But your mom doesn't buy you stuff. Actually, your mom's probably do buy you stuff. What am I saying? Anyway, normal Nuzlocke rules apply. The capture rates don't, excuse me. The capture rules don't apply until I actually get Pokeballs. So, this does not count as my first encounter. And thank God, because it's a rat. It's a rat. It's a dirty rat. I would much rather not have a rat attack. What I'm probably going to do is I'm probably going to play up until the point that I can get Pokeballs and call it a night, because I am actually recording this at 1:05 at night. Oh, God. Oh, God. That was bad. Okay, yeah, that's the way that the... If there was one thing that the, Gen 4 and 5 were dumb with, it was the way they actually handled the sprites. I don't like it. It's just... The perspective... doesn't quite work. Like, I'm much, much happier with Gen 6 and the way they handle everything, because everything's a 3D model. And 3D models, do angles better than sprites. Gen 5. I love Gen 5, but it does a lot of things with, it does a lot of stretching that it shouldn't do. And it's pretty bad. Once again, the issues with the... Oh, God. Oh. I cannot look at... Alright, yeah. I think next recording, I'm going to go to 2x magnification. Because I cannot deal with some of the stretching. It's pretty bad. So, if I go from 2.5 to 2, I'm going to lose more of the screens. But, I'm gonna not want to kill myself because of the sprites, so that's probably the better option. Actually, what I'll probably wind up doing, because I do have a bit of energy here, I'm probably gonna set my computer to a different time zone after I stop the recording. But don't tell anybody. I'm just gonna skip back. Actually, at this point, I don't think I could skip back to any point that would be a better time to play, because I don't particularly want nighttime Pokemon. Hold on. Okay, and sorry about that. My sister just came home from a party. And I didn't want to bother her, as aforementioned, it is like 1 in the morning, and she has work at 7 in the morning. So I decided to move somewhere that is not directly next to her room to continue recording. Anyway, let's finish getting these sprint shoes. All right. Now we can move around a bit faster than before, which is nice. Let me heal up. Because that's always nice. Yes. That's always just a refreshing thing to hear, the healing thing. Once again, sorry if it suddenly sounds like I have low energy. It's not that I have low energy. In fact, I have pretty good energy right now. I'm just trying to be a little bit quieter for my sister. Anyway. Actually, I've gone downstairs. I've literally moved about, like, maybe 20 feet from where I was. It took a lot of effort to move 20 feet. But it happens. Noise travels through the walls a lot easier than it does the floors. So, anyway, I wasn't actually looking at the screen, so I'm just gonna go up this way. Ah, gonna get the map. Map is nice. Oh god, oh, I just looked at that item, and I cringed. I can't wait to start a new recording so I can fix this. I probably should have already fixed it, by the way. I probably should have stopped the recording, and, reset it after, I came home, but I came downstairs, but I didn't feel like it. I don't know why I didn't feel like it. I'm gonna actually have it be like an end of an episode sort of thing, and then I'll start the next recording immediately. I don't have nearly enough content for a whole episode yet. That's also the nice thing. Totodile learns its elemental attack at level 6. Eat that, Cyndaquil. You may evolve first, but fuck it. A Totodile at least gets a very good elemental coverage right away. I mean, not that Water Gun really helps in the slightest right now. Oh, right. I'm gonna have him come out and not go in and have him do his spiel, but this is literally a forced dialogue right here. It's annoying. I was literally about to walk in, but I didn't feel like, because I knew he was going to stop me anyway. I just didn't feel like going into his house, being a creeper. By the way, that's the weird thing about RPGs, right? You just don't give a shit about people's personal space, and you just walk into their houses without even knocking. At least in Animal Crossing, you knock. Did I not take that item that was down at the beginning of the route? I don't think I did. And this is also why I'm resetting, changing the time after I give Pokeballs. It's because I don't want to deal with all these Rattata everywhere. Because it is ridiculous. I would much rather have a Sentret. I've got a very specific name for Sentret when I get it. And by the way, in that original save file that you saw, I pretty much had a bunch of joke names that all referred to the run that Ted was doing, but I decided I didn't like it. So part of the reason why I'm glad he had to reset, which allowed me to reset, I was just running on Steams there. Like, it was dumb. Anyway. Here to get... Oh, look, it's a familiar face. That guy walked up really fast. That guy's super zippy for an old guy. And now he's going slow. It's like, why is... Oh, he was going slow because it was a fragile egg. That's right. I like the fact that he's like, oh, 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 and then he's like, don't break the egg, don't break the egg. Ah. Dang, I didn't really need that. Oh god, Professor Oak is so slow. Literally, he's the slowest character ever. Oh god. Oh. Why does Professor Oak look like he was placed in a very bad Pokemon Sprint comic right now? He did not look to be on the same plane as the main character for a second, and that was weird. I don't like it. I don't like it. He looks out of place a bit. I don't like it. Oh, now I got the Pokedex. I got his phone number. That's nice. Actually, you know what? I'm going to end the part here. There was a lot of technical difficulties to start off with, but I'm just going to go out and I'm going to save and start the next part. So... okay, I'm back. I guess this is part two. Yeah. So, I mean, it has to at least be part two. Part one's probably going to be pretty short, because I've literally got nothing done. But I will progress anyway. Actually, you know what? I think I'll call that part zero. Literally nothing happened. And I don't feel like tacking it onto this part, because it's just more... actually, you know what? Screw it. This is not part two. This is still part one. Literally nothing's happened. And, you know what? It's just... it's going to be a little bit more work for me, but it's just going to work. I'll just edit it all into one. Have to rescale everything. Anyway, I don't know if I'll do this yet, but I'll probably take a book out of Pro Jared's, take a page out of Pro Jared's book in the way that I want to. Oh, probably should change the time. Yeah, well. I'm gonna beat this battle, I'm gonna save... set like the emulator real quick with a changed time, just so that I can get Pokemon from earlier in the day, or I guess in this case later in the day. Time is weird, so let me see. Probably can't actually see what I'm doing at all, although you might, so I'm probably just going to edit it out. Just go to, I hope this works. I don't have to completely reset the emulator. I gotta completely reset the emulator. God damn it. Hold on. I'm just gonna get back to where I was. I'm gonna scrub this video. Oh wait, no, fuck. I can't scrub this video anyway. I've already leveled. Alright, well, this video is a bust, so... okay, the game now thinks that it's 3:30 p.m. as opposed to 1:30 a.m. This is much more... much closer to where I wanted to actually be. So, yeah, there we go. That's daytime. So now, if this is all part one still, that's now three different videos I need to work with. One. Just getting a little bit extra, a little bit more beef before I have my beef with the life. And it's always fun. Anyway. Oh, the walking still makes me want to kill myself. Doing it sometimes two times three didn't fix it. Oh, well. I guess I just don't like the walking sprite from this game. At least the side walking. It's very distracting to me. I mean, it's... I don't like it. What's Snappy's health at right now? 19? Could use that extra 5 hit points, probably. So I'm gonna heal you up, and then once you're all healed up, I'm gonna go fight the rival. By the way, I much rather prefer his, is that what I should name him? Alright, I know what I'm gonna name the rival. I think that's actually what I did in my original run through of Gen 2, because I actually thought that was his name. I was a stupid kid. I mean, no, I was being like, oh, I get to name the rival at this point in the game. All right, you know what? I'm just gonna name him what his original thing popped up as. So. I decide to be smart or stupid, I'll probably be naming the rival through question marks. That's not what the encounter is called here, but the joke still stands, in my opinion. And, yeah. Alright, so Snappy. A level 8. Learn Rage. And Totodile learns its fourth move pretty damn fast, all things considered. Also, in the original game, he literally tells you his name, but it's like blank when he says it. Oh no, you saw my name. I don't know, Snappy, did you see his name? Oh, Snappy seems a little tired. I'm gonna heal you up, Snappy. In a snap. Yes. Okay. Time to head back to Newbark. That was it. Newbark is the name of the town. Blanked a bit on the name for a sec. But it's Newbark Town. Okay. Go talk to Professor Elm. And the police officer who thinks that I did it. For whatever reason. And Lyra has to save me. And I prefer the original version where I talked myself out of it with no dialogue. But you know what? This makes a lot more sense if you're trying to actually work in the character of Lyra. fuck it. All right. Do I want to do it? I'm sticking to it. Sticking to it. Actually, no, I got a better idea. What? No. I'm sorry, what? If I do two? That's... So if you put in spaces, it does a default name. No, his name was not Hart. Okay. Do I want to? Nah, calling him douche is overplayed. Shoot. Hashtag. No. There's not enough room for hash brown. Hashtag trending. Actually, is there? Definitely not enough for hashtag trending. Actually, his name is hashtag trendy. That's it. Yes, his name is hashtag trendy. Oh god. I just named my rival hashtag trendy. Oh my god. Why did I do that? I like how he's so surprised that there's an egg. He's the master of Pokemon evolution. Or, so to say. If there was a master of Pokemon evolution, he would be the one. And now he's surprised that I got a Pokedex, and blah, blah, blah. Wow, he literally just doesn't, trust the fact that we could beat this. Alright. So, I'm actually going to say goodbye to my mom and not leave and then have her call me and be like, why didn't you tell me goodbye? Because that's what happens if you don't tell your mom that you're leaving on an adventure. Yes, I would like you to save some money for me. Alright. Onward we go. Now we gotta sit through this whole nonsense. We're battling a Rattata. I really wish we didn't have to sit through this tutorial. But I guess we have to. Do we ever fight Lyra? I don't recall if we ever fight Lyra. I don't think we do. Also, why did they create a new protagonist when they already had one from Crystal? Made no sense. No sense whatsoever. But what are you gonna do? Anyway. I got the Pokeballs. Yeah, that's right. Lyra didn't know that I had... I messed up that joke. I'm not even going to continue that joke. You can imply what I was going to... the joke that I was going to make from that, but I fucked that up, so I'm not even going to bother. Oh! First encounter. And it's a Pidgey. I like Pidgey. Don't want to kill it, so I'll switch. Oh god, I just sneezed away its health. Pokeball, cool. As much as I love to do superstitions normally, I think it just get a little annoying if the controller inputs are being picked up. Which I don't know if it did. I checked the video to make sure that it was synced, and it was, so I'm like, okay, I'm gonna have no issues with syncing, at least. Which helps out a lot, because, you know, that is a significant amount of doing Let's Play stuff, is making sure the audio is synced and all that extra shit that you gotta do to it. So I'm gonna nickname this Pidgey, the same nickname I give all of my bird Pokemon that are male. Claude. This is a... it's kinda like Cloud. And if it's a girl, I name it Claudette. Alright. So that's one encounter down. And do we go back to Elm and heal up Claude? Actually, yeah, we'll do that. And put Claude out in front. No. Fuck. There I go, being indecisive. Costing me time. I think there's a plane going overhead right now. Anyway, I'm gonna catch the Pokemon that I can catch to the north. Well, I don't know if that direction is north. I assume that direction is north. I would have preferred my first Pokemon to be Centret, because I want Centret. But I keep running into battles. I don't want to fight because I don't want to get too strong. I don't want to knock out Pokemon in one hit yet. I want to do that while I'm grinding, but not yet. Alright. Go up to this route. Route 46. Who am I going to encounter for 46? It is... ah, sweet, the Geodude. Alright, that's a level 2 Geodude. Alright. Now, last time I did this, I fucked this up, and I wound up spamming Rage. And accidentally getting a crit on it. And right now, it looks like I might be able to just catch it from here. So I'm gonna try this. I think it can eat one more scratch as long as it's not a crit, but I don't want to take my chances, to be perfectly honest. I've already critted one Geodude to death and missed a catch. I don't want to do it to another, because this is going to help out... this is going to help out the next two gyms a lot. Because I have nothing. Well, I mean... I'm going to have nothing that'll... unless I catch a Mareep, I'm going to have nothing to take care of... take care of the second gym. That's going to suck. Give a nickname to Geodude. Yes. Once again, the same nickname that I give to all of my, actually, you know what? I'm not going to go with that one. What am I going to name you? I shall name you... Well, I can't make a Golem reference because I'm playing on an emulator and I won't be able to evolve him to Golem. Which sucks, because I would love to have a Golem on my team. Which means I also can't get Gengar, which is also going to suck. And if I happen to get catch an Abra, I won't be able to get Alakazam. That's going to really guilt my process a bit. So... This is tough. Anyway, I guess now that, unless I catch a Sentret, my naming convention will be going as follows. I will tend to go for secondary characters of movies and television shows as the names. I will do my best to not name them after a protagonist. So, for example, this rock male is... Oh wait, hold on. I want to make sure that I'm spelling it right. Just wanted to double check that that's how you spell Bolin. Okay, now I'm gonna go back and heal my Pokemon. Because now that I got three Pokemon, I'll be able to better deal, as you would say. Actually, I don't know who would say that. But anyway, I'm much more well-equipped to... Right, not home. It's not Gen 1 or any other gen. This is Gen 2. And the healing machine is here. Love that sound. Alright. So... who do I want to train up first? First things first, let me take a look at these guys. So... that is... well, I have two... what? Alright, this is a Nuzlocke run. The first three Pokemon that I have are all Jolly Nature. Alright then. I'm going to train up Bolin a bit, because if I get him to have Rock Throw, that'll help out a lot. And right now, he actually can probably single-handedly take out these people, because they're only going to do one damage to him. And that's going to be nice. He's not really doing all that much either. This is slow, so slow. But it's worth it, because he's going to get full experience for knocking out this Pidgey. It's going to be great. And he's going to level up a little bit faster. then if I swap to Snappy. But took out that Fidgey. Relatively no problem. And that was not worth it. Bought a level 2. I got 15 experience. That sucked. Okay, that sucked. I'm just gonna outright say it. You know what? I'm just gonna sweep. Snappy sweep. Hashtag snappy sweep. Hashtag trendy. Why did I name my rival hashtag trendy? Why did I try to base it off of a joke that I've only made to myself, hashtag trending, and when that didn't work, I just abbreviated it to hashtag trendy. That's a lot of Pidgey. I am surprised. I don't know the encounter rate, but I was expecting more center. Oh, shit. See how much more experience a level 3 Pidgey will get. A level 2 Pidgey gave 15, and when it split around, unfortunately, it gave 15 experience. A level 3 Pidgey. So, effectively, I'm going to see 11 and 11. So, either 22 or 23. For a level 3 Pidgey. That's not too bad. I'm just gonna get out of grass. Oh. I'm gonna heal up. Alright. Alright. Let's see what the next Pokemon that I will encounter will be. Alright, so my Route 30 encounter is... another Pidgey, doesn't count. Alright, I'm gonna solo this Pidgey. This is gonna take a while, so... Oh, crit. Nice. Oh, it crit me back. Man, this is so... Oh, double crit. Alright. Hopefully don't crit me back. Thank you. HP from that. Yep, I was right. 23. Alright, Bolin got to level 3. More defense, more HP. That's good. Okay. Oh, I missed the green apricorn at the beginning. Oh, well. Because I forgot that I already had the box. Another Pidgey. This one I'm just gonna not. I'm gonna switch to Snappy. Alright, anyway, so I guess I'll... When I was doing the joke, everything is a little bit of a parallel to Ted's playthrough. He named his Cyntaquil a secret. So I named my Totodile to everybody. Can't get it. My secret to everybody. Right. And I named my rival Viag, I believe. which was looked stupid. And I regretted it the minute I did it. And I'm like, and I named my Pidgey Gusty Oak. Because he had Ash Peckham, I had Gusty Oak. Actually, I kind of missed that name, but nah. I'm going with Claude. Oh well. Not to be confused with Claude, the insult often spewed by Peridot. Oh, a crit. I might want to heal, but I think I should be good. Anyway, and my encounter on this route last time was a Kakuna, and I hope it's not a Kakuna. Oh, it's a Weedle. Awesome. Which means it'll actually be able to attack. Unlike when I had to do the Kakuna, and all it knew was Harden. That sucked. Tackle. Alright. Just chip away at this Weedle. Catch it. And don't get poisoned. Motherfucker. I told you not to get poisoned, and what do? You go and get poisoned. Each is doing one damage. So I'll land this tackle, and then I'll swap to Snappy, and I'll throw a Pokeball. Just in case the Pokeball doesn't do it. I mean, it's probably not going to. It's a level 3 Weedle with low health, but I need to make sure. I can literally not take any chance. It's a Nuzlocke run. I last used. Again, not using the touchscreen because that would require using the mouse, and I don't want the cursor in the video. It just looks unprofessional. There we go. Weedle caught. Alright. So This is a name I am keeping from the last attempt. So Ted had the name for the actual name for Bayonetta, which is a Sega game. And that's it. Yes, the Sega game. Forgot for a second. And Sonic, and now I guess Bayonetta, is also in Smash. Mega Man is in Smash. And Hornet Man is a Robot Master. That's how I got to Hornet Man. And I like the name, so I'm sticking with it. Ah! Right. Poison. That's another Weedle. I don't want Poland to die. String shot. That's cute. Luckily, this is Gen 4. So, well, I keep calling it Gen 2, even though it's Gen 4. It is a Gen 4 game. It is a Gen 2 game that takes place in Gen 4. Or it's a Gen 4 game that takes place in the region from Gen 2. So I will always call this a Gen 2 game, even though it takes place in the engine of Gen 4. But luckily, you know what, I'm gonna swap to Claude out front. Because I figured something like that would happen. You know what? Give Claude some experience now. So there's going to be a lot of this for right now. Because my other Pokemon need to get a bit stronger, a little bit more beefy, before I can really move on. since I already have a Geode, I'll probably wind up catching a Zubat in Dark Cave. Which means I might be able to swing in... Which means I'll if I catch a Zubat now, means I'll definitely be able to force a Slowpoke and Slowpoke well. Which is nice. It's a free psychic type. And I might be able to try to force an Onix in Union Cave, which will also help out a bunch. Alright. That's gonna be cool. And I will... Oh god, game slowed down a lot for real. Right there. There we go. I'll keep Claude out front for now. I'll get Claude to level 4, then I'll get Hornet Man to level 4. We'll go back to, This will get Claude all the way up. At least level 3 with this. I'm not gonna bother talking, so I'm gonna speed this up. Oh wait, I know a way that I'll be able to make this go really fast, real quick. Funny thing is, all I did was not limit the frame rate, and I was able to go this fast. Actually, pretty nice. Oh, there we go, got a crit. There we go. There we go. So nice. Alright. Yeah, I literally just healed, so I'm good. Oh. We encountered a Pokemon in the exact same spot. Just did. I really wish you had a flying type move right now. Not gonna lie. Why do you get Gust so late? Yeah, String Shot. Make the Pokemon that's slower than you go even slower. This is the fun part of Pokemon. Grinding. And if you're asking, hey, why are you grinding this early? Because fuck you, that's why. No, literally, I'm just grinding. And, with a Nuzlocke run, there is no point you should not be really trying to get your Pokemon as high as a level as they can be. Because sometimes a random battle will, the grass battles will almost never kill your Pokemon unless you're stupid. Looking at you, Ted. Rip in peace, 421. I knew you well. For about 10 minutes until Ted went against a similar leveled Bellsprout, used Vine Whip until the other one ran out of Vine Whips and it struggled them both to death. Ted is smart. No, I don't want to take that chance. Go for the easy sweep as opposed to the balance leveling. Because that's always got to be, that's always got to be what you got to manage. Is you got to manage how you do your leveling in this game. Because if you have one Pokemon that's just stronger than the rest, if that Pokemon dies, you're fucked. Like, being perfectly honest, you will die if you don't have a well-leveled team. If you have one good Pokemon and the rest are shit, it's not going to do you any good, in the slightest. So, always have a team. Always is probably the best advice for me. I'm just going to go right. I'm just not even going to bother. Not even going to bother. Because you're going to get poisoned, I'm going to have to run back and lose literally all of my progression. But if I just off the wheel now. Man, it sucks that... Oh, wait, actually, I never checked Hornet Man's, nature. I swear. Alright, so, letting everybody know. There's no cheats. So, if it's a fourth Jolly, what the shit? Moment of truth. Wait. Oh, it's Rash. Oh, I can't believe I, keep looking at the wrong screen. Because I'm an idiot. Yeah, Rash nature, so... three Jollies and a Rash. Wow, that sounds like the name of the worst porno ever. Three Jollies and a Rash. Alright. Alright, so I know I said I was going to get Hornet Man up to level 4, but I'm just going to swap in Bolin right now. Because Bolin will resist Joey's Rattata. So hopefully I'll be able to take him on no problem. I don't need to defense curl this early on in the game, because that's a quick attack. Rattata's currently strongest move, and it only did one damage. So, barring a crit, which will ignore defense curl anyway, there's no reason to worry about raising my defense. It might be more useful later on. However, that might be an issue. But no matter, Bolin's got this shit covered. See, with one Tail Whip, it did twice as much, which is, two whole damage. Actually, when your health is 17, that is a sizable amount, but... I wanted Bolin to take that one down. Because Rock beats Rat any day. Yes, you can have my number, Joey. Just don't call me on the weekends. Actually, it's a weekend right now. So, whenever you get the urge to battle. No, Joey, you won't call me whenever you get the urge to battle. You call me whenever you run into, like, a Pidgey in order to brag about your top percentage Rattata. I will... No, fuck it. I don't care if it's Rattata, I'm calling it a Rattata. Rattata, damn it. It's a Rattata. 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 Top percentage Rattata. Alright. Now, Hornet Man, you go in front. Wow, also, surprisingly lack of women on my team, which I had no issue with last game, where a good portion of them were women. So... should be able to take down this boss. It's not gonna know Gust. If I can poison it, that'd be great. Come on, poison. Come on, poison. Poison it, please. I need that extra. Please don't crit me. Please don't crit me. Good. Don't crit me. See, now, if you only triggered, like, two turns earlier... keep that one. Hold on a second. Oh, that's why. So, now I will go Pokemon. Hey, Bolin, you should be good for this, right? Oh, shit. Wow, this Rattata is actually stronger than Joey's. Because its quick attack just did... Oh, no, now it's doing... I think I was just seeing things before. Oh, and a crit. It died. Ah, yes. Hornet Man grew to level 4. And will Bolin grow to level 6? Nope. Alright, so that's the guy that beat Joey, and will always be known as the guy that was better than Youngster Joey. And what do you want? I'm not a trainer, but if you look one in the eyes, prepare to battle. Okay. Instead of Bogepoke, when I found a trainer. Yes, yes you did. Caterpie! Hornet Man. It's only gonna know tackle and string shot, so Bolin, you're up again. Oh no, my rock is even slower than it was before. Oh, how will I live? I almost used Mud Sport. Oh no, I've got 9 health left. How will I survive? See, I'm talking shit now, but I'm gonna get critted so hard. I just know it. Oh, well, you know, I totally did. If I was that Caterpie. Level 6. Nice. Switch Pokemon. Give one of them some more XP. I want to get... I'll probably end this part when Hornet Man becomes a Kuna. And I'll probably call it a night. It is actually pretty late. I have to check my actual watch for the time. Because I changed the time on my computer so that I could actually catch not the Tata and I would much rather prefer Pidgey over Hoot. Yes, I said that. Pidgeotto always will have a special place in my heart. Because I loved the anime growing up. And, you know, Pidgeotto is like the bird Pokemon. The second he got Pidgeot, he totally ditched it. Which sucks. Okay. New encounter time. I'm gonna heal. Hold on. I don't remember setting LB or RB to anything. I must have set them to L and R. Because it went through different, tabs, but... I'll leave Hornet Man the way he is. Alright, and this route I will get... Oh, yeah. Because it didn't say it before, Dupe's Clause is in effect. But Ted had, like, a very specific Dupe's Clause where he said that if he... when he lost his Bellsprout, like that one. Okay. Then when he lost his Bellsprout, that he wouldn't be able to catch a Weeping Bell later on. Meaning that if I ran into a Kakuna, I was not going to count to beat him. I threw out Claude because Claude's going to resist Vine Whip. Even though I think Hornet Man would have also resisted it. Hornet Man also did not have that much health. And I would prefer I not lose Hornet Man already. Because Beedrill can learn Cut. And that'd be very useful to have. Alright. So, Bellsprout was caught. My first female. What to name her? What to name my Bellsprout? Darn it. I was going to be creative. Alright, so here's the thing. I'm like, I'm going to, like, in the movie Half-Baked, didn't Dave Chappelle's character have a girl that he really liked? I'm like, what was her name? Looked it up. Tried to be subtle with the joke. I tried to be subtle, and I set up, I'm gonna name it after the girl from Half-Baked. Half-Baked was Mary Jane. Her name was already a reference to weed. I'm actually disappointed in that movie right now. Alright. Well, this is a rare opportunity where I'm going to speed it up again using the same method of that way that I did before. So, hold on a second. Unlimit the frame rate. Oh, God. I'm also going to keep my eye out on Vine Whips, make sure that it doesn't get to the struggle point. Actually, no, this is gonna... this might get to struggle. Because it's looking pretty bad. It's at 8 now, and I'm barely made a dent in Kakuna's health. Please get a crit. Do not fight. Do not struggle, please. It's Hornet Man. I don't want to split up the XP too much. I got a poison sting into death. It's going to be pretty damn ineffective, but it can't be any less ineffective than Vine Whip was. Alright, that did the trick. Alright. Hornet Man grew to level 5. Yay. Mary Jane didn't level from that. So, I'm not going to go into Dark Cave quite yet. I'm going to heal first. Going for it again. It's too hard to not just to just ignore all that XP. Hopefully I poison Kakuna and it just goes a bit faster. Actually can't no, you can't poison a poison type, that's right. Huh. It's gonna be hard. You know, I'm glad that I was able to just speed it up in-game and not have to worry about it in post. Because it's less editing I have to do. The less editing I have to do, the better. Because that'd be nice. And I won't have to cut this down too much. I'd like to just leave it as is, but I know there's some parts I probably need to trim. I mean, there's probably just going to be a lot of silence every now and then, but figure I might as well just get everything all nice and neat. Oh right, I was getting back on topic from something I was saying before. I'm gonna take the Pro Jared style and the I guess it might already be on screen. I'm gonna take the Pro Jared. Oh, I'm gonna unfast forward it. Because it doesn't fast forward during the overworld. Because it doesn't quite hit the actual frame rate for the overworld. So limiting the frame rate won't do anything. Well, unlimiting it, rather. Won't do anything for the overworld. But it speeds up Pokemon battles like nobody's business. Because there's, like, no environmental effects. Which is what slows this thing to a crawl. Alright, so the way I'm doing the eggs this time is the first thing I'm going to do. I'm going to do my next two encounters. I'm gonna do Dark Cave, then I'm gonna do the, I forget what route that is, but, the one that's just south of town, I'll do that one, and Dark Cave, and that'll be the end of, the ones I'm doing for now, because I'd much rather get a... Hold on a second. Alright, first things first. Hey, it's a Zubat. I'll just do Poison Sting on a Zubat because it won't get poisoned. And that's a nice, easy way to, not kill it. Though, these trades will... pretty bad. It's gonna keep leech life in me. I'm probably doing two, then it's healing one, is what I'm guessing. So if I get a crit, it'll do a little bit more. Or if he gets a crit, two. Heal. Ugh. I'm probably doing like three or four. maybe. I don't know. I don't know how much life a Zubat has. Oh, shoot, I think I only have one Pokeball left, too. Oh, I really hope I don't waste this encounter getting the Zubat, because then there'll be so many more chances for me to get a Zubat. Oh, I don't wanna not catch this Zubat. I should have bought more Pokeballs when I went into town. I was stupid. It seems I just need to slowly inch down this Zubat's life. To get it down into the red. And then it'll heal itself a bit more. I'll hit it one more time. Now one more time. Yep, that was close. Okay, so here's the thing. I didn't use save states or anything to manipulate that at all. My recording hit 1 hour, and I realized that my Windows 10 DVR was set to only record for 1 hour, and I wasn't paying attention. So literally the second after the Pokeball was thrown, the recording stopped. And I caught the Pokemon. I'm like, oh, better explain what happened before I move on. So that's what happened. Caught the Zubat. Yes. And I will name the Zubat Jason Todd. Never actually was Batman, but I don't care. Well, I guess he was dressed up as Batman at this one time. But never officially Batman. But I felt like using his name as opposed to, like, Dick Grayson. Mostly because I don't think Dick Grayson would fit. Or Dick Grayson would not fit. Grayson would fit. But not the same. Alright, so now I am at 6 whole Pokemon. One of them is a Zubat, which is literally just caught so I will not have to deal with catching another Zubat. Which hopefully will help me out a bit. Okay. Sounds so much better when you have 6 Pokemon. Alright, anyway, as I was saying, I keep getting off track, but what I was going to say before was the way I'm doing eggs is I'm going to do the encounter that's right below not the gym. I want the mart. Do the encounter that's south of town. I think this one has the Pokeballs. I was correct. Seven Pokeballs. Alright. Oh, I should have bought 10. That I would have gotten a Premier Ball. I'm an idiot. Oh well. Anyway, if I don't catch a Mareep, I'm going to use the egg to get a Mareep. Because I like Mareep. I like Ampharos. As I stated before, Ampharos is one of my favorite Gen 2 Pokemon. I never stated what my Gen 5 Pokemon are, I'll probably get to that another time. But Route 32, my encounter is, I hope not Arbok. It's a Mary. Awesome, 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 awesome. Alright, I'm gonna do this very carefully. I'm gonna swap to both. Mary will be able to do nothing to it, because all it has is Growl and Tackle. Growl will knock down my attack, which will let me do almost nothing to it, and allow me to chip it down to basically nothing. Meanwhile, it will only be able to do one damage to me. I forgot about Static. That might be an issue, but regardless, I will be catching this Mary. And it's a female too, nice, which means I'll be able to use the other name that I will use for a for an Ampharos if that also breaks my naming convention, naming it after secondary characters. But well, I guess it is a little bit of an insult to Bolin to say he's a secondary character, because he leads a couple episodes, but I'm saying that he's not the main character of Legend of Korra. Korra is the main character of Legend of Korra. Her name's in the damn title. A titular character, if you would. That is not a reference to her breastises. That is the reference to the fact that her name is within the title. That was dumb. But anyway, Bolin is not the titular character. He is an awesome character. And Season 1, he was Sokka Light, and really came into his own in Season 2. By the way, Bolin, that's like Season 1 had a lot of, like, moments. Season 2 was filled with a lot of except for every time Bolin was on screen. Because every time Bolin was on screen, you know where you were in time for some entertainment. Because he pretty much invented the role of being a movie actor. Which is pretty awesome.
No!
Crits. Well, I know what I'm getting from Primo. And that sucks, because I would have got, if I, not the Pokemon Center. If I was going to catch that Mareep, I would have gotten a Slugma, and I would have had great type coverage. I would much rather have an Ampharos over a Togekiss. Oh, that was painful. Oh my god. Oh. Well, that's a note to end it on, I guess. I think this is all part one. I think this is just gonna be one long part one, to be perfectly honest. That's right, I was going to address the weirdness from Dark Cave. I'll go back to Dark Cave. I guess this is, an issue with the way that I'm doing the, enlargement of the screen, which, you know, doesn't seem to be an issue until I get to hear the darkness doesn't cover the whole screen. Wow. That's interesting, actually. Another encounter. What else could I encounter in Dark Cave? Now I know I said that I would end when Hornet Man became a Kakuna, but I'm gonna end it here. I need to go to sleep. I'm tired. This is a fun first part. I didn't end on Sprout Tower, unfortunately, but I will continue on at a later date. So probably put this up before the BrainScratch comes next stream. So I will catch you guys whenever I post part 2.